Hi everybody, this is Lindsay from WindingRoadCrochet.com, and today I'm going to show you how to make this quick and easy cup cozy. If you like this tutorial, make sure to like, subscribe, hit the notification bell. You can also follow me on Instagram and Facebook. So one of the things I really like about this cup cozy is that it actually will fit both a mug and a travel cup, and it looks really great no matter what colors of yarns you use. And I even made two different variations of it. So I'm going to show you how to make a smooth variation and how to make a ribbed variation. For this pattern, you're going to need a size H 5mm crochet hook. You're going to need worsted weight yarn, scissors, buttons, and a yarn needle. So let's go ahead and get started. You're just going to make a quick slip knot, put your hook through, and we're going to start by chaining 8. We are actually making the buttonhole here. So just go ahead and make a chain of 8 chains. Once you have your 8 chains, you're going to slip stitch to the very first chain. So we're just going to pull that through to slip stitch to the first chain. And now we're ready to start our first row. We're going to do this by chaining 1, and then we're going to make a single crochet into the next chain. All right, just one stitch for this row. Now we'll start row 2. Chain 1 and turn your work. And we're going to work 2 single crochet into this one stitch. So 1 and 2. All right, now row 3. Chain 1 and turn. We're going to work 2 single crochet into the first stitch, so 1 and 2, and then we're going to single crochet into the next stitch. Chain 1 and turn, row 4, we're going to single crochet into the first stitch, do a second single crochet into the first stitch, and then single crochet across, which in this case is going to be just 2 more single crochet. So we're going to repeat this a few times. The repeat is going to be chain 1 and turn, work 2 single crochet into the first stitch, and then just single crochet across. You want to continue doing this until your row ends up with 11 stitches across. So here I am. I'm going to chain 1 and turn. I'm on row 11. I'm going to do an increase into the first row stitch, and I'm just going to single crochet across. I've been doing that for the last 11 rows, and this is going to be our last row of increases. So when we finish that row, we're going to chain 1, and for this row and all the rest of our rows, we are just going to single crochet in each stitch across, and just keep repeating that until you have a total of 53 rows. So I chain 1 and turn, and now I'm just going to single crochet in each stitch across. And this is how we are going to create a smooth cup cozy. Now, if you want to do the textured cup cozy, I'll show you how to do that in just a moment. So then you would just repeat this row by chaining 1, turning, and single crocheting in each stitch across, and repeat that row again until you have 53 total rows. So now let's say you want a ribbed cozy. Well, that's easy. We're going to do the same method, but this time we're going to single crochet into that back loop only. So you'll chain 1, turn, and single crochet into the back loop only of every stitch. And that is going to give us a beautiful ribbed texture. When you reach the end of the row, you would just chain 1 and turn, and then repeat that, working single crochets in every stitch across in the back loop only. And again, repeat this row until you have a total of 53 rows. And that would give you a beautiful ribbed texture. So here I just finished row 53. I decided to continue using the ribbed variation. I am just going to snip my yarn, yarn over, and pull it through the very last loop and pull that tight. So our cozy is almost done. We're just going to weave in our ends real quick. So using your yarn needle, You're just going to thread your yarn through your yarn needle, and then you're just going to tuck this thread under several stitches, just going under the bottom of several stitches. And then it's always a good method to go back and forth at least 3 times. This is a cup cozy, so it's probably going to get dirty and it's probably going to get washed a lot. So we just want to make sure that those yarn ends are nice and secure. And then you're going to do the exact same thing on the other side. I would just make sure you take it down a few rows more into the project as you weave it in. So the last thing we need to do is sew on our button. So I'm just going to grab my mug. This is one that my sister-in-law designed for me. And wrap it around and decide where I want to place my button. To fit a standard cup like this and then the standard travel mug, I like to sew my buttons to the 37th row. But of course, you can always grab your favorite mug and just test it and see where would be the best place to put the button. Now for me, I'm just going to take my yarn ends on the backside and I just knot them 3 or 4 times on the backside and clip my yarn ends instead of weaving them in, but you're always welcome to weave them in as well. So there, it will be all complete. If you feel like you need to, you can also try this around a travel mug. And though my button seems to work for both of them, you can add a second button if you feel like you need to. Originally, I did add a second button and then later decided that it wasn't very necessary. I really hope you like this video tutorial. Leave me a comment below letting me know what your favorite quick and easy project is. And as always, thank you for watching.